Hello everybody, my name is Walter, and today I want to show you how you can build a variation of a piston feed tape that is not only flush with a flat surface area, but also has no gaps inside of the tape itself, which is a design that was inspired by a recent video from Mamo Jumbo, where he built a 3x3 ring in the floor that shifted around or rotated around when the button in the middle was pressed. But his solution was a bit complex and overcomplicated in my opinion, so I thought I would give it a try myself, and the results you see in front of you. So let's start with a few little examples. So in this case I have a 3x3 ring in the floor, which shifts around, and here you can already see how this works. So in a normal piston feed tape you need gaps in the corners, or at least one corner, so you can shift around without pushing the blocks outside of the tape. Since we have a gap-free piston tape, we have to first make those gaps. And this works by first moving the second to last block out on each edge, and then we have a gap. And the next step is then moving those blocks we just moved out or pulled out towards the side, and then pushing them inside of the feed tape again. So as you can see, this is essentially what's going on in here. So a very simple, very easy to understand concept actually. So of course the same thing can be built as a wall version and as a ceiling version. The ceiling and the floor version both have only one module type essentially, and if you put four of those together you get, for example, a ring. The version in the wall has, due to the way redstone works, four different modules. So in total I will show you in this tutorial six different modules and how to build them, and also later on how you can interconnect those three systems. So it's also possible to have transitions between, for example, the floor and the wall. But more about this in a few seconds. Anyway, since this is basically just a normal feed tape, piston feed tape, you can also put them together into more complex designs. For example, cross shape here, which shifts around clockwise if you press the buttons here in the middle. Very simple to understand and also nice to look at. A little side note, since one of those blocks here, or some blocks, get retracted, there is a little chance that you might fall into this here, and when they are pushed upwards again, there is actually a chance that you are getting stuck in here and suffocate. Just a little side note. So when this shifts around, you don't want to stand on top of that. And I totally forgot to talk about the size limits, so a little insert here. The length of one of those edges here is limited by two things. The minimum is either two, so basically you just have one shifter that's rotating it by 180 degrees, or six blocks. The six block limit is when you have concave corners, like here, then you will need additionally modules inside of the ring or tape, which means that if you don't want the shifter here to crosstalk with the feed tape at the back, you will need at least those six blocks here. If you have this situation in the wall, you might have to even replace some of the blocks at the bottom with redstone on top with glowstone blocks or upside down slabs to not influence those pistons there. So, and that's the minimum limit, and the maximum limit is a total of 13 blocks, since the last two blocks of each edge get handled separately by the shifter, or by the following shifter. So in total we have a maximum size length of 13 blocks here. Okay, so, and the last example is this a bit more crazy one, which also has all five possible transitions. So floor to wall up and down, between walls, and floor to ceiling up and down. And as you can see, again I went with a clockwise direction or shifting. Of course, if you just mirror the entire thing, the rotation goes into the opposite direction. So, anyway, this is the few examples I prepared for you. Don't worry, I will put a link in the description for a word download, so you can have a closer look into how those things here work. Since I will only explain the general ideas behind that, and the finer details may deviate a bit depending on your situation. So anyway, with that done, let's talk about the size. Well, since the layout heavily defines how much space you need, this is not really easy to say in before, but what I can tell you is the space requirements for the various components. And that is the feed tape itself, which is just made out of those one-by-one modules here, essentially just observer-triggered piston, which moves the feed tape inside of the flat area or back behind it. And the other type of module is the actual shifter, which is usually a 3x3 footprint and 4 blocks high. And that is pretty much true for all different types of shifters. And the only deviation here is the shifter from horizontal upwards, which is a 3x4 footprint but 3 high, so in total the volume is the same. So, anyway, that's the sizes. Now let's talk about the required resources. So for each shifter module, you will need a couple building blocks, then on average 3 redstone dust. The shifter in the floor is 1 redstone less, and the shifter on the right here, so the shifter downwards towards horizontal, is 1 more. Then 2 redstone torches, 1 repeater, 1 observer, 2 normal pistons and 1 sticky piston, and the glowstone is only needed for the shifters that move from upwards towards horizontal and from downwards towards horizontal. For all others, this is not really necessary. And for each of the feed tape blocks, essentially, you will need a normal block, then a block that's shifted around, 1 redstone dust, a sticky piston, and possibly, or in half of the cases, you will need an observer. What I mean with that is, in the floor, you need an observer for each of them. In the ceiling, you don't need any observers. And in the wall, for the horizontal components, you need observers everywhere. And in the vertical components, you need only observers for every second or every other block. So it's a bit difficult to tell in before. The glowstone here has to do with a possible piston bug, which sometimes gets involved when you have several pistons right next to each other and power them with normal blocks on top that have a redstone line on top. Some of them may get confused a bit, but this can be easily resolved with some glowstone. So, and additionally, you might need some button, for example, as an input, then some additional redstone, dust, or repeaters, or torches, maybe a piston and an observer combination to transmit the signal. One example would be right in here, where I have a button which powers a normal piston, which has an observer below it, which powers this block there. So just to make sure that I can get the power right from the center down here, without actually influencing the sticky pistons at the bottom here. So that's the standard modules. Now I talked about transitions between those three systems here. For each transition you will need a couple building blocks, then around 2 redstone dust, 2 repeaters, maybe an additional observer, and 2 normal pistons. And additionally you might need some glowstone, maybe redstone dust, torches, repeaters, or observers to interconnect the various systems with each other, since there is, due to the change in direction, a little gap that has to be filled in. So, anyway, that's basically all you're gonna need. So let's show you how to build those modules and transitions. So let's start with the floor. The first step is building the actual feed tape, which is simply the tape at the top. Then 5 blocks lower, you have this line of blocks with a redstone line on top. Maybe you will have to put a repeater in somewhere in here if the power gets not to all of those. Then on top of that we have our line of observers, and on top of the observers we have the sticky pistons with the one high gap to the actual piston feed tape, which is at the normal floor level. So this is the beginning. Then while we are there, we can already build in our button. In this case, this button powers the normal piston here, which then triggers the observer, which powers the line on there. And this should be the result of that. So now, once we've done that, it's time to build the shifter. And for that, it's important to know in what direction you want to shift. And let's say we want to go essentially in a clockwise direction, represented by this piston here, which means that we have to go to the side where the blocks are coming from, which is this one here, then from the corner 2 blocks inwards we place a normal piston right at the gap, or right next to the gap, then a sticky piston diagonally like that, and right pointing at this corner another normal piston. Then we go below that, and at the second to last observer we place another observer, then 2 blocks diagonal like so, a repeater in here with on 2 ticks, then a torch on top of there, then a block here, now the sticky piston should extend, then a block diagonal there and here, put down some redstone dust on top of those 2 blocks and a torch here, and that's the entire thing done. So let's see it in action. And now this thing here works. This gap would have been closed by the module before that, or the shifter before that. This here would have been moved by the shifter after. So that's the floor part done. So let's go to the ceiling. Again, the first step is building the actual feed tape. In this case, it's a bit simpler since we don't need any observers at the top. The rest is pretty much the same way. So sticky pistons are right, hovering above our feed tape, then the normal blocks on top with redstone line on top. If you are having problems with a piston bug that some of the pistons won't spit out their blocks if they get a 1 tick pulse, then just try to replacing some of them with closed-on or upside-down slabs, and then it should work. And once more we have our button with the normal piston and the observer here, which triggers the entire thing. If you don't power this with an observer, you might want to add a torch as an inverter to make sure that when the button is not pressed, the blocks are flush with the ceiling. Again, let's give it a try. And once you're sure that everything works, it's once more time to start placing the pistons. Again, first step is figuring out in which direction we want to go. Again, I want to go towards the back essentially, so in this case it's counterclockwise. Once more we start 2 blocks inwards from the corner and place our normal piston like that, then the sticky piston diagonally and another normal piston right next to that. Then we go to the second redstone there and place our observer. Once more we place the 2 blocks diagonally like so, then repeat on 2 ticks, the torch towards the corner side, then a block right behind the sticky piston, raised block here, put down 2 redstone dust, a torch here, then another block down there and some more redstone dust. And that's once more the entire thing for 1 corner. And with that done, it's time to give it a try. And as you can see, this whole thing here works, so this gap would have been filled in with the previous module, and this one here would have been moved by the following. So that's the ceiling done, and with that it's time for the wall. wall modules. So now for the wall modules, again, the first step is building the feed tape itself. In this case, as you might notice here, the horizontal components all need an observer, and the vertical components only need an observer every other module or every other tape block. So, what is important is that you make sure that all of those here get triggered. Again, I have used a normal piston with an observer to give it a short pulse at the back here. And as you can see, this is the first step already working. Then next place is the placement of the pistons. For this, once more, we need to first figure out in which direction we want to go. In this case, I'm going clockwise. So going with essentially the direction of this piston here. Then go to the one corner, again to inwards, place your normal piston right next to the gap, or below in this case. Then diagonally to that we need a sticky piston and a normal piston right next to it. And this has to be continued on. Which should result in something like that. Next, let's go and start at the bottom here with this module, which shifts from horizontal upwards. There, let's start at this normal piston, block behind it, block diagonal inwards, a torch on the side of it, now the piston should extend, then block diagonal and next to those pistons here, redstone dust down like that, two blocks like so, then repeat on two ticks here, torch there, another block here, and finally an observer facing downwards like that. Next, let's go to this side here, which goes from upwards towards a horizontal. For that, let's go to this back here. First, a glowstone on the side of it, this piston with redstone on top. Then two normal blocks like that, redstone dust there. Cut off this wire here. Then a torch there. Then, right below the torch, we need an observer in this direction. Again, once more, over two blocks like so. Then a repeater on two ticks there. Torch here and a block on top. And that's this module done. Next, let's go to this second side here, which is from a downwards movement towards the horizontal. Here we have to start with a glowstone block like so, another normal block here, another two blocks there, redstone on top of them, then place two blocks like that, a torch in here, a torch there, then we need another block down here, and a repeater on two ticks there. And now it depends, if you have an observer here, you can directly place an observer there. In this case, I have a gap here, so I place the observer in this gap, and a normal block to the face. And that's this part done, so let's quickly get to the top part here. For this, just place three blocks like so. Redstone dust on top, then a torch here, which should power this piston there. Then two blocks like so, torch in here, another block there, repeater on two ticks there, an observer here, and another normal block on top. And that's this part also done. So let's give it a try. And as you can see, the entire thing is now finished. So now for the transitions, I will show you only one example, since all of them are built the same, just rotated and a bit rewired correspondingly. So in this case, I will show you the transition from a floor to a wall module, which means that the blocks will be moved clockwise, as you can see here. The first step, once more, is building the feed tape until you reach the point where the feed tapes are conflicting about this corner block here. So if we give it a try, we would see some strange things going on here. And that is the point you have to build this up. Again, you will have to connect both feed tapes with some additional redstone. If you are running out of signal strength, you might want to place, for example, a torch here and then replace this one here with a normal block. Just keep in mind that you then introduce an additional delay, which makes a bit of a difference in the timing or the synchronizing. So anyway, once you've built it this far out, it's time to replace a sticky piston with a null piston, and that is the last sticky piston, which is looking in the direction we want to push all of those blocks here. Then we place another normal piston diagonally in the same direction, and the last part is powering this normal piston here 6 ticks after those pistons here are powered, or to be more precise, after the next module gets triggered. So, and to do this, the simplest solution in this case is just some redstone here, then an observer, so we have the same timing as those here, and then diagonally some blocks, then 2 repeaters on 3 ticks each, a redstone there, and now we have our delay, which means that we can give it a try. And as you can see, this block here would have been moved from with the next module, and those ones here would have been moved inwards by the previous module or shifter, which would have ended in a configuration like that. So just what we want with that. Okay. So that was how you can build my flush and gap-free piston feed tapes. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, and well, see ya!